Hey, yo, what is up, everybody? Chuck here, and welcome to Wrench to Commander, episode number 6. If you have not caught up on all the previous episodes, I invite you to pause. Pause this video, and if you click on that little I in the right-hand corner, it'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All those episodes, make sure you catch up first. There is no shame in falling behind. There's a lot of footage here. Okay, so people have said, change your class up. Well, I don't really have much else to change. I want to put on Ghost eventually, and maybe like Dead Silence or whatever, but not yet. But not yet. You know what? Actually, how about this? Let's try... Can I put on Blast Suppressor? Instead of Gung-Ho? Here, let's try Blast Suppressor. Just so if I'm trying to sneak around behind them, they won't necessarily know. And I'm actually going to go with Sparrow today. We're going to roll with Sparrow. We got the UAV care package, Hellstorm. And, of course, we are going to be playing Safeguard. Now, I want to thank you guys very much for all the positivity on yesterday's and the previous video, episodes 4 and 5 of the Wrench to Commander. There's some people who want to come to my videos and be negative. And you guys do a great job of basically shutting them up. So thank you for that. We haven't quite hit our light goal on the past two episodes, or three, or four. But that's okay. I still love you guys. And I'm still going to put these out. It just would encourage me to put out more of them more frequently if we hit those goals. So today's goal is just simply 1,000 likes. That's it. You know, there's 1,000 people that are listening to this right now. Maybe not right now, but like in the next 10 minutes, 1,000 people listen to it. And maybe not even 10, 30 minutes. Whatever the case may be. There's a lot of you guys listening to it who will watch it for minutes or 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever. And all it takes is like a half second to show some appreciation for the work that goes into these. So thank you for those of you who do that. This lobby looks like a fucking superstar lobby. I want a lobby where nobody's fucking prestige. That's why I normally play TDM. Here, fringe safeguards, always the shit. What can I wear? Oh my god, I have so many gestures. Oh, wow. Knuckle sandwich. Wow, never seen somebody look more intimidating. That's like the weakest knuckle sandwich ever. It's like her fist happened to fall into her left hand. That's better. That's a little bit more intimidating. What do we have for first place taunt? Go on, run. I'll give you a head start. Oh my fucking god. You know what? I bet a female created all those. $20. Because if you put a guy in charge of that, those characters would be so fucking aggressive. And actually intimidating, which is probably the point of it. But it just doesn't... I don't know. Okay, here we go. I don't... I actually kind of prefer being on the other side where you can sneak up behind the people trying to escort the robot, but it's okay. Another thing we got to get to this episode, and I'll try to pull these up basically like in between games and in between rounds, whatever. Q&A. I asked you guys to leave me a bunch of questions for the last episode. So, we should have plenty of questions to go through. I went through and I already saw that you guys had left like 200-something questions, which is great. I'm not going to be able to answer all of them. Obviously, that would be an entire video in itself. But I will try to answer as many as I can. Now, let's find these motherfuckers. Where they at, though? Okay, a triple combat axe to start off the game. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. I might as well just escort this because I need my fucking points. Like, for real. We gotta escort this shit. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. But they're waiting for us. But it don't matter! Oh, he got him! Still not enough for UAV. You need, like, 14 kills in Safeguard to get a UAV. You think I'm being sarcastic? I am a little bit. I think it's actually 10. But still, that's a lot of fucking kills. I'm fucking money right now. Let's fucking go. What? I'm gonna get the bank shot off the robot? How the fuck? Let's keep it rolling. I was about to get another bank shot and shit would have hit the fan. Alright. Fuck. Where they at? You know, there are some days that you just feel like you're on top of the world. And I think just hitting a triple combat axe has, like, changed my outlook on the day. I don't know why, but there are some days where, like, a video game can really change, like, your attitude for the rest of the day. Like, if you're oh, shit. Look at all this shit in here. Like, if you're playing like shit, you know, and you think you're good at a video game, and you spend a couple hours playing, and you go, like, 4-19 every single game, you're gonna have a shitty day. Like, you're gonna be feeling like, wow, I have wasted so much time trying to get good at this game, and I'm terrible at it. So all it takes is, I mean, if I get into a lobby and I start fucking some kids up, that's like a morale booster. All right, I do need some help, though. So if you guys want to help me escort Paul Garcia Wall or Astox or whatever whoever the rest of you guys are, we're trying to get kills here, and we're trying to move the robot. So it would be helpful if you guys would go over to that fucking blue thing. So this dude right here, quick question. Okay, you're coming now. You're good. Thank you. Well, you're almost coming. You're on the verge of coming, but you didn't come. All right, yeah, you go super fast mode, CFG, bitch. All right, it's all good. Here we go. We could do some fun here. We could have some fun. Oh wait, yeah, I got time. We got a nice little hit marker. Great. Let me be the one to win the goddamn game for us. I need those, because those give me a lot of XP. I think you get, like, I don't even know how much, 1,000? Okay. Decent start. We're off to a decent start. Now let's hit that fucking robot. If I can hit him with both of these, that counts as me finishing the series. If I get two hit markers right here, that counts as me winning. I'm done. Like, that's the end of the series. Really? Neither of them? I think that means I have to do it again. I have to do the entire series one more time. Just kidding. I would never do that. I would, however, consider doing it again if I were to unlock the butterfly knife or brass knuckles, because that would give you something else to see. You know, the reason I did the wrench is because it's different than a knife. Like, it's a little bit, there's a little bit more variety to it than doing a standard Road to Commander with a knife only. Because a lot of people do that. I've done it a couple times. Bullshit. Oh, that dude took my fucking wrench! What a dick! We must kill this man. It sucks that everybody has Dark Matter now, because when I had it, it was cool. Because I got it within like 2 weeks of the game being out. Now everybody's fucking got it. Now it's not cool anymore. Life sucks, man. Life sucks. Suck a dick. People are going to be complaining, no doubt, about how many kills I'm getting with this shit. With the combat axe? You know it. You know somebody right now is leaving a comment, Chuck, you're too good at the combat axe. This is supposed to be a fucking wrench to Commander. Use your goddamn wrench. No, I'm going to... If I have a way to get a kill, and it's going to entertain you guys, you're damn right I'm going to do it. Combat axe kills are probably more entertaining to watch than a regular wrench kill, so quit your bitching. Quit your bitching. You're a fucking bitch. That's all you are. That's really the extent of your existence on this earth. You're a fucking bitch. Watch out, man. You trying to get killed? There. I don't know what else I have to do for this team to win. You gotta watch out. You have no awareness, Pony D. You have no fucking awareness. You're sitting there. It's over. Alright, we gotta go overtime. That's fine. We can do overtime. We can do this. Okay. Alright. Let's get into some questions, though. I'm gonna sort by newest first, so I'm gonna gradually get to your questions. So if you left a comment right when the video came out, yours is gonna be at the end of the video. If you have a recent... They'll be right now. So, will you be doing open lobbies for this series? Probably not. Maybe, okay, I shouldn't say that. When we get to the end of it, this question is from Multi Awesome Vids. Thank you for the comment. when we get towards the end of the series, and I mean like we're like level 53 or whatever, then I'll probably do some open lobbies and try to go for kill cams, maybe for like the last couple episodes, because I know that stuff that interests you guys. So towards the end, not in the middle, because that'll just take away time from actually playing, which is, I mean, we're trying to get this done in the quickest time possible. It's not like all or nothing where the point is to get kill cam. Sorry for the burp. So hopefully that's understandable for you guys. Chuck, have you seen Star Wars yet, and what do you think of it? This question is from Pat Failey. Pat, I have not seen it. I am not a Star Wars guy. That dude's such a fucking bitch. How fast is he? Like, how fast are you, man? Anyway, no, I'm not a Star Wars fan. I never have been. And I have there's nothing against it. It's the same with me and, like, Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings. I don't really like fictional story. I don't know. I like real stuff. I like real stuff. Obviously, this is a video game, and I do video games for a living. But, so that doesn't make sense. But you know what I mean. I don't like the huge series that I'm going to have to dedicate 12 hours of my life to understand. And then again, there's also like, and this might sound bad, but there's like a stereotype that goes with Star Wars and Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter. So they all kind of go hand in hand here. And that stereotype is almost enough to keep me from, hold on. Of course that dude had fucking, what's it called? Reject. I'm not going out there with you, so that's all you, robot. You gotta haul yourself. You're escorting yourself at this point. Shit out of dick. Alright, let's try this out. Where the fuck? Rip! Really, nigga? So, part of me is like, okay, if I want to watch this series, I'm going to have to fucking read all these comic books and watch all these fucking other movies that came before it and read fan fiction. And there's so much that goes with it that, like, for me to just start at this episode, at this whatever number it was in the series, I don't even know, be a lot of work. So, no, didn't watch the new Star Wars movie. I'm sure it was great. From what I've heard. Pretty basic question from of a type. He says, how tall are you? He's 5'8 and he's 15. I am 6 feet tall. Pretty spot on 6 feet. Pretty even. And I think I hit the peak of my height when it was after high school. Which is weird, because girls are done growing basically by the time they get to high school, which is why I always find it funny in middle school when you see like those, you see, like, kids go to the mall or go to the movies or whatever, and, like, the boys look like they're 12. Oh, wait, they are 12. The boys look like they're 9, right? Because they haven't grown. They've grown, like, maybe 2 inches since they were 10. And then the girls look like they're, like, 17. And it's just like, is that their little brother, or what's... Oh, God. I don't deserve this kill. I got it, though. Fucking Jesus, man. We have to get this fucking robot there. Angel has been doing a great job escorting. We do have 3 people with 1 second or less, though, so I'm going to blame them if we don't win here. It's not hard to do this, to just push the robot there. What the fuck? I hate that guy. I remember when I got Dark Matter and put him on fucking dual-wielding SMGs, you little bitch. They're already destroying the shit. Move it! Move it, motherfucker, move it! Fucking push it! Go! Push it! Push it. Jesus Christ, guys. Come on. Yeah, so I hit my height peak. Probably about freshman year of college. Which is late for some people, but that's just what it happened. So it's... You're welcome, guys. 426 is not a good time, but at least we got it done. We can still win. So, yeah. 6 feet tall. Hit it around probably age 18, 19. Will I ever... okay, this is 420 Skate for Cancer 420. He says, will you... interesting name. Will you ever play older video games, like retro video games, on your channel? Those games may include Mario 3, Contra, Mario 2, or the like. So, I don't really know how I would go about accomplishing that. If I had my PS2 still, but I got rid of that years ago. If I still had it, I would totally play, you know... Jet Moto. Nobody knows who, or nobody knows what Jet Moto is, but that was like my favorite game back in the day. Or Spyro or Crash Bandicoot, stuff like that. I used to love those games. Tekken, the original Tekken's, so good. But it's not something I see me doing with my channel. Because I'm trying to grow an audience, and I think most people come here for Call of Duty. So it's hard. Like, I throw out anything other than Call of Duty, and all the people who want Call of Duty would be like, "Jerk! You little bitch! This is not Call of Duty!" And that's exactly how it go. How did he pull up his gun? That's not true. That did not happen. That is not fiction. That is not non-fiction. That is fiction. You're a bitch. I hate you. I hate all things associated with you. I hate your family. I should just destroy the robot here. Fucking bitch. You're in there? You're doing that? You have to escort the robot, you fucking idiot. Whatever, let him sit there. Let him fucking sit there. That's fine. So, retro games in the future on my channel, probably not gonna happen. And there's nothing against them. I don't know that I would enjoy playing them as much as I used to. And I wouldn't try to, like, force it because I think that'd just be stupid. So, it's just not something I would enjoy doing right now, I guess. I love this game. I love Black Ops 3. You wouldn't see me making a series like this if I didn't enjoy it. I was done with Advanced Warfare by about this time when it was released. So, I'm still loving this. So, we're gonna keep rolling with it. Hopefully, you guys are okay with that. I'll pick out a new question in a second. First, let's... Well, you see, I'm doing well. It's just that their fuckers are killing me. What's another question? Well, I already did that. What was the hardest weapon to get gold camo? Some of the launchers were bad. The lock-on launcher was just awful. Just a pain in the ass to do. Just because you have to basically rely on people to get, like, sentry guns and shit in your game. And because I was going for Dark Matter pretty soon after the game was released, not many people had it unlocked yet because it's a late unlock. It's like it's one of the higher levels. So nobody had that, but I had to destroy them, so I was kind of shit out of luck for that, so it took a while. So yeah, what are the lock-on launcher for sure. If you play uplink, you can grab the ball and get kills, and you get a shit more XP than you do in TDM. Yeah, I could do that, but... that wouldn't be using a wrench or a combat axe. So. You're such a bitch. Like, that dude has not... I don't know what makes him think that that's a good idea. I don't understand. Bitch asses. I need to go in there and kill him. You're such a fucking idiot. You're just straight up, you're just dumb. So are you. What the fuck? I didn't even get that kill? Oh shit, we gotta hurry this up. This is not good, this is not good. No! God damn. You know, I'm just gonna blame my teammates for everything, because there's just... I don't know. I feel like there's a lot of people who have no idea what the fuck they're doing. They think it's TDM. Especially fucking Tango Sucker. Who literally didn't leave that room the entire game. We lost. Fuck me in the ass. Okay, next question. If you win the Powerball... This is from Tony. Tony Lyons. He said, if you win the Powerball and could only spend money on things... By the way, I didn't win. I did not win $1.5 billion. And you could only spend the money on things that start with the first letter of your name, what would the list include? Okay, so it would have to be a C. I would be buying a lot of cars. I'm lucky because I have a C. Cars. Oh God, what else? I would be buying a lot of cabinets, a lot of crack cocaine, chickens, plenty of chickens for sure to put in my cabinets, and then give them crack and then just see what happens. A castle. I'd probably buy a castle to park my cars at. So that would be my list of things. A castle, some cars, some chickens, and some crack, and some cabinets. How much did we get? We got 16,000 XP. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. I just like playing these games because I feel like I'm spending less time sitting in between and waiting, and more time actually just getting to play, which I enjoy doing. So I want to do Fringe again. Now, what are we close to accomplishing for challenges? That's the question here. I need to win some games. I need to win 7 games. I need to win a match of Safeguard. I need to get 250 score streak kills. So maybe what I should do is put on... You know what? Let's try this out. Let's try out ACXD, because I feel like in Safeguard, you might have a decent chance of getting some kills with it because everybody's around the robot. So we'll try that out. Please don't give me Tango Suck on my team. I don't want Tango. If you give me Tango, I'm going to be bitching this whole game. Don't make it happen. Don't make it happen. This game, are we going to start or what's going on here? Okay, Tango's the other team. Thank fucking God. Okay, did you stumble upon the wrench or did you blow money on it? Asks R. Finks. That's a good question. So originally my whole theory was I'm not going to spend any money on it. But if you watch my live streams, you know people like to throw money at me. And we had a bunch of money donated. And it was all donated for the purpose of opening supply drops. So technically, I wasn't blowing my own money on it. I was blowing money for the enjoyment of others. Totally worth it. We got the wrench. So we spent quite a bit of money on this. We probably spent like $140 on it total to get the wrench. But since then, I haven't bought any supply drops, so I haven't gotten anything cool. Still hoping one day I'll get the brass knuckles or the butterfly knife, but who knows? Who knows if it'll happen? Bob Smith says, "Why you suck dick?" All right. E-Money Bacosa says, "What made you start doing knife-only games?" This is a common misconception here. I've never been knife-only. The only exception you see of that would be All or Nothing. But All or Nothing was basically a knife-only game mode with the exception of the pistol. And even when All or Nothing started, I used the pistol. But then I thought it was cool. I was like, hey, I mean, I can fuck everybody up without having to use the pistol, and I want to prove that to people. And that's what started the whole FSU thing. So it wasn't that I was like, hey, I'm a knife-only dude. I'm going to play this basically knife-only game mode. I was never knife-only to begin with. I just wanted to prove that I could fuck people up without having to use the gun. Because the gun was annoying. Even though I used it. So that's the answer to that one. And the name Straight Up Knives actually literally means straight up knives. Like that. Like not only knives, but actual straight up in the air. So there's that to clear up any confusion. You guys are going to get some good knowledge out of this series, hopefully. Some good facts that'll help you. Oh god, their whole teams are here. Got him, baby! Got him! It's actually huge to go in there and disable the robot. Even if you think like it won't mean much and they're still going to win, it's huge. Because it basically puts them off about 15 seconds, I think. Maybe it's 10, I'm not sure. But that's a lot of time in Safeguard. And if you destroy it a couple of times in a really, really good area, I mean, you're going to fuck them over, you're going to win the game. But I don't think most people realize that. They're just kind of like... Most people don't play the objective anyway. I got a kill with that? The fuck? Okay, now I'm on a kill streak though, so I don't want to be banging at the robot. Somebody in here? Yep. Pretty accurate with the combat axe today though, if I do say so myself. If I do say so myself. We'll get to another question in a second. I want to do, how about this? Keep the questions rolling in so we can always do Q&A. That dude's a bitch though. Like, you're a bitch. That's what you are. What the fuck? They're moving it that fast? Stop it! Watch the fuck out, man. I know you're in here.
Hey!
There's a minute 58. There's no way we're gonna win this game. How the fuck, man? That's so annoying, because I was on the kill streak too. And I decided I wanted to be a team fucking player and start taking out the robot. And nobody's going to take out that robot with me. Oh, did I? I got it with the axe, so I'm the best. You're a dick. Running around with fucking dual SMGs still. A whole game later. It's not like you're using them to get dark matter. You already have dark matter. Put that shit away. Put that shit away. For the OG fans. You know what that's from. Yeah, what do you think you're doing here? What do you guys think you're doing? You can't move that robot on me. You can't move that robot. Oh, shit. They're gonna move the robot, aren't they? I'm out. Ah, shit. It's so close. It's literally just like one person getting there. So I have to take out everybody behind it. So I just take out nobody and they're gonna win. It was up to me to win this game. I didn't do it. I choked. I did disable it twice, though, with an axe and a wrench, though, so I should win. Next question. Blazing Cheese, he says, my question is, what will you do... No, I can't read. Will you do any event-type things that will involve subscribers and fans? I went to E3. That was in June of last year. Well, technically... Yeah, that was June last year. That was 2015. So I went to E3, I actually met a couple of viewers, which was really, really cool. It's kind of strange, though. I like it, it's cool, but I think some people go there with the sole intention of meeting viewers, and I think that's kind of weird. Why am I not getting any credit for escorting this thing? Like, I don't even want to escort it, I'm not going to get credit for it. There's so many people out there. Fuck them. Fuck them in the ass. Dog, you are not helping our team sitting back there. Just fucking go. Let's go. Let's go. Push it, even if you're gonna die. Just like that. But it takes more than one person to do this, everybody. So whoever's sitting over there, you're being an idiot. Was that a dead body? I hate you, CFG. You're not even good. You're just running really fucking fast, and it's annoying as shit to kill with a wrench. Well, somebody killed the dude in the ground. Thank you, somebody. Thank you, whoever killed him. So, will I be going to any events in the future? Oh, man, I don't know. E3, I'm sure I will go again at some point. I would have liked to go to TwitchCon this year, but it just didn't work out with scheduling and stuff, so we might actually go to E3 again next year. So if you live in the California area and you like going to those things, keep an eye out. Just follow me on Twitter, you'll know. I mean, you'll know before I would ever announce it on YouTube. You'll know like the second I decide to go. So alright, I need to stay alive here. We have plenty of time to win this. My goal now is just to get a little HCXD or some shit. No! God, it's so annoying. Okay, we got the W though. Well, we got one round. So I'll probably go to E3 again because I'll be out in LA anyway for a wedding. So we'll see. We'll probably do E3 again though. Here's a question. No, that's too long. I'm doing better than expected. Thank you, Nov1M. Okay, TM Snow 131 asks, if Black Ops were to release a new specialist, what weapon and ability would you want them to make? That's tough. Because I have to just basically pull that out of thin air and try to come up with something. I don't know. They've done a really good job, I think, with the specialist, with the exception of Glitch and Reject. I don't like either of them. I just don't find either of them useful. So to some people it might be useful, but that dude, does he see me? No, he's retarded. That dude is actually retarded. What level is he? He's level 24. He's not getting a kill this game. I promise you, he's not getting a kill. All right, so we got to stop him back there. But they're moving it. Oh boy. I just gotta not get killed from behind here, and I'll be able to hopefully get a few kills running in here. It takes a while. Okay. Alright. Does he have a kill yet? He's 0-4, so we're still right on our prediction. I'm trying to think. They already have invisible. I mean, I'm trying to think of, like, superpowers you can get. But I can't think of any superpower they haven't accomplished. I mean, you can already fly. You can go invisible. You can see through walls. Those are, like, the three superpowers that people ask for. So I don't know what else I would pick. I don't know. If you guys have any suggestions, you can drop them in the comment section, and I'll probably revisit them for the next episode. But we're going to skip that question because I don't know. Maybe some sort of, like, maybe it would be a more of a weapon type thing. Something that would shoot out axes, maybe. People move so fucking quick side to side on this game. I don't know how they do it. Anyway, we'll get to the next question in a second. I'm going to try to... Oh, no, that doesn't... Yeah, that would make too much sense to get that fucking kill there. So, fuck this. Q&A. Do you prefer throwing knives or combat axes? You know, people might think otherwise. I prefer the combat axe. The knife is cool, but the way the axes bounce around and stuff, I think allows for a lot more creativity with them. So I'm gonna go with the axes. The knives are cool. You know, I don't not like the knives. I just think that, you know, there's just more to do with the combat axe. So yeah, there's the answer to that. Zayd with the smiley face, but with the sticking out its tongue face with the P. Asks, how's your mom? Good one. She's dead. Just kidding. She's not dead. But that would have made you feel like shit, huh? I didn't get credit for disabling the robot. Are you kidding? Anyway. Ollie Knives says, how long do you think it'll take to get to the commander? To finish the series, some math has been done by our statistician. No, that's not the right word for it. By our stat keeper. And the consensus with that is going to take about... Hold on. Is Camper Dude still in here? I'm just going to keep doing my circles. Keep doing my circles. Come on. Oh, shit. Well... Okay, how long do I think it'll take? I think the consensus is that it's going to take another 26 episodes, I think it was. Might have been 36, actually. 26 to 36, so we still have a ways to go, so don't get too bored yet. The second I pull out the Sparrow, I just automatically die, and then the other team wins. It happens every time. Just keep an eye on that. You dead, bitch. Fuck. They got 420. Blaze it, motherfucker. So I prefer the axes. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, how long it'll take? About 30 days, probably. Or 30... Whatever it's called. What's it called? 30 episodes. It's an event. Ethan says, hey, Chuck, really appreciate taking the time to make these videos for us to enjoy. Anyways, I would just like to say you deserve more credit. You're an amazing YouTuber. Keep up the great work. Thank you, Ethan. I appreciate that. I like the kind words. Alex McDonald says, do you think the Buffalo Bills have something good to work with now that Tyrod and Sammy have stepped up? And what's their opinion on the Ryan brothers coaching the team? Side note, yes, I am a Bills fan, and yes, I'm an alcoholic. I wasn't going to imply that you were an alcoholic. That was never part of my assumption. But thank you for admitting that. That's the first step. So maybe we should drop a phone number for you to call. But anyway, I do think the Bills have plenty to work with. I mean, Tyrod Taylor's good. Sammy Watkins is good. Those two go very well together. So, hold on. Move it. Move the robot, boys. Move the robot. I'm just going to chill here. So I do think you guys have quite the future there. A young quarterback with a good receiver. Reminds me a little bit of the Dante Randy era. Just obviously different players, different styles, but yeah, you guys have stuff to work with. I'd be happy if I was a Bills fan. I mean, what's sad about being a Packers fan is that, yeah, Rodgers is still kind of young, but he's getting to the point now. I mean, he's getting up there in age. He's getting there. And that's scary to think about because it seems like he's only been our quarterback for like a little while, but he's been our quarterback for like 7 years now. Maybe not seven. I think it's probably been like six, but still. No, it might have been seven. Guys, you went the wrong way. You guys are chilling in that room. We got to get out here. That would have saved the game right there. I think we won anyway. Good work. Who the fuck did that? I think that was D-Town Boy. Shout out to D-Town Boy. I'm Fatness says, do you remember like 3 or 4 years ago when XJMX Blaziken submitted a setup video for one of your community challenges and you called him out and now he's in phase? Yeah, I remember that. I used to have Blaziken on my channel a lot. And now he's in phase. That's good for him. But yeah, I do remember him setting up some clips back. I think everybody set up clips back in the day. Especially knifers. Knifers tend to do that. I can honestly say I have never intentionally set them up. If people decide they want to get killed by my things in the air, that's fine. But I've never set up a clip. But I will call people out if I see it happen. That crazed kid says, how is life after college? Also, what did you major in and are you going to put it to use? How is life after college? This may sound weird, but okay, we're going to play one more game, by the way. We're going to drop one more game here, make this around a 50-minute episode, probably. We leveled up in both games. That's pretty good, I think. You guys agree? And we'll level up again here. Okay, let's play another one. Are we going to do Fringe Safeguard every game? We are. Okay, that's fine. Life after I miss learning. And for those of you in high school, you guys are going to say, fuck learning, fuck school, fuck everything. No, believe me, there's something about like constantly being fed new information, new things, new ideas, new theories, whatever. There's something about having that coming into your daily life that makes you just like more... I don't even know how to describe it. I miss learning. I miss learning new things. I mean, I can obviously still learn. I can go pick up a book and learn how to program or do something like that. But I think part of it was that I was forced to do it. Doom Spawn Trap and Doom Max Turbo. The fuck are these guys? Doom Spawn Trap barely has a better score per minute than me, and I use a fucking wrench. Doom Max Turbo's ass at this game. This will be fun. Anyway, I majored in economics. And am I going to put it to use? Eventually, yes. I'm hoping probably in the next couple years I will say, okay, Chuck. No, I'm not saying I hope this. You know, obviously I hope that like I boom again, my channel goes crazy again and people go gaga. But if that doesn't happen, you know, I'm going to put it to use. I'm not going to waste my college education. I do kind of wish I would have gotten a degree in marketing or advertising because I feel like what I've done on YouTube is basically that in a nutshell, marketing, advertising yourself. But regardless, it was worth it. And totally worth going to college. You get the experience and meet the friends. There's a hit marker. Look, they both landed in the same fucking spot. Look at that. They're like literally, they're in each other. Oh, there's a dude in that corner. It's probably that one camping bitch from earlier. If I had to say my favorite weapon was in any COD, what would it be? Oh my lord. You guys are giving me the tough questions. I like it though. I like the tough questions. I don't like when people ask stupid shit. That dude just got a quad in like a tenth of a second, so props to him. Favorite weapon in any COD. It would have to be a tie probably between the M40, the R700, both from COD 4. The Intervention from Modern Warfare 2. I really like the UMP-45 from Modern Warfare 2 as well. That's probably my favorite reg gun of all time. I would put the wrench up there. I think the wrench is definitely a top 5 for me. But I liked the old Infinity Ward Modern Warfare series sniper rifles a lot. This is ridiculous. Oh my fucking god. Man, you should be able to take out, here's one petition. You should be able to take out multiple people with one swing of the wrench. They just won that shit with, like, just easy. Like, there was no fucking defense. What the fuck, man? Jesus, and I was right behind their whole team. I don't even think they play. We only had three people, so I got, and one of them didn't get a kill. So it was me and this other dude, nobody else did anything. Great. This is great. Making these doom faggots think that there's not 1 in 3. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. So yeah, favorite guns would be the UMP intervention M40 R700, and the wrench probably. DXP Blade says, "I love your vids, man. Fuck anyone who goes here to talk shit about your channel because you're more successful than they will probably ever will be. So keep it up, fam. Thank you very much. That's not a question, but I appreciate it." I'm Hectic says, "I forgot to type my question earlier. Do you think Antonio Brown was faking it after the hit by Perfect? Also, Starks or Lacy? Starks is more all around, in my opinion, but Lacy would be my every down back." I don't think Brown faked it. I think Adam Jones is kind of a tool to begin with. So I don't know if he faked it. His claim was that Antonio Brown winked, but even if he did wink, that doesn't mean he faked a concussion. It could just mean like, hey, you're an idiot. Thanks for giving us the win type wink, not like a, I'm faking an injury wink. So, I don't know about him faking it. I think that's kind of far-fetched, but... also, Starks or Lacy. So, we got a big game coming up, boys. We got a huge game coming up on Saturday. This is going to go live on Friday. I'm recording it on a Thursday. Got the club going up on a Tuesday. But, Starks or Lacy? That's the question. I would... It's tough. By themselves, I don't think either of them are incredibly useful. But I think together, if you use them in tandem, and you're confusing a defense, I think that's the way to go. Suck a dick. Suck my whole goddamn dick. All of it. Put it all in your throat. All of it. That should have been a fucking double kill, but... Sparrow fucking takes 19 seconds to shoot it. It's like somehow you can fly and shit, but you can't shoot a crossbow in less than 8 seconds. Okay. So I think you have to have both. If you're talking about for fantasy football, I would go with Eddie Lacy. Starks, you don't know if he's going to be out there. Lacy, you know he's going to get carries. He may not do much with him, but he's going to get carries. Oh boy. Shit. What do you do? I had one axe. I couldn't do much else. Starks or Lacy? Yeah, I gotta go with Lacy if you have to pick one. But together is when they're most effective. And if you're a Packers fan, you know that. You know that. Next question. This is from D West. He says, "What is your favorite non-Packer football player in the NFL? And do you follow and root for J.J. Watt and Russell Wilson since they're former Badgers?" Oh boy, here's a tough one. Favorite non-Packer. Hold on, let me do some things here. Favorite non-Packers gotta be. I don't really like J.J. Watt. I don't like. You know, I liked him as a Badger, obviously. That's what happened. You guys remember that episode before? You fly when you walk over that a certain way. I didn't jump. That would have been a bitchy little jump if I jumped there. Favorite non-Packer has got to be... Oh, God. I don't even know. That's a tough question. Their whole team's back there. Let me fucking get a cross map. Come on. Give me some luck. No, that didn't hit. Ah! Oh my god, I almost got it there by myself. Where the fuck is my team? That should be the fucking Q&A question. Chuck, where the fuck is your team? Somebody ask that for the next Q&A question, please. Somebody fucking... Because I want you guys all to leave a question right now. Leave a question for the next one. Good work, boys. Good work. Yeah, Doom Spawn Trap. Nice work picking up my wrench, you little whore. God, I don't know. I'm trying to pick a favorite NFL player that's not a Packer. I couldn't even pick a favorite Packer. It'd probably be Aaron Rodgers, but Jordy Nelson's probably a close second. So I can't pick a favorite non-Packer. I definitely don't root for Russell Wilson anymore. I think he is such a tool. I'm sorry, but his whole mantra of like, oh, thank God for everything. Thank God, 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 God. And then he started dating Sierra, and he won't have sex with her until marriage. So, I mean, he totally fucked up. But and then he plays for Seattle, and Seattle's fucked this over too many times. So, no, I don't root for Russell Wilson despite his collegiate career. Who joined my game? I don't like when people join during these. You win some, you lose some. Whoever it is, they better be doing bad, or they better be doing well, because if they're doing bad, I'm going to kick them and make fun of them. Because that's kind of how I play. If we can destroy this right here, we will be at such a fucking advantage. But, you know, it takes... I don't know how they didn't kill me. I mean, that's fine. If they want to waste that much time not killing me, that's cool. I don't root for J.J. Watt or Russell Wilson. I think it's cool that the Badgers are putting out so many good... You know what? Okay, here we go. Here's my favorite non-Packer. Melvin Gordon. That was easy. I actually should have... That should have been my answer right away. Wish he was doing a little bit better with San Diego. But the Badgers running backs. They got a lot of running backs in the league. We got Monty Ball. Melvin Gordon. James White for the Patriots. So if you're a Patriots fan, he was a Badger. And what's crazy is the Badgers basically had all these dudes at the same time on their team, which is why they made the Rose Bowl, like, what, 4 years in a row? Didn't win it, but they made it. So, yeah, we put out some good running backs recently, which is neat. And I guess Wilson, no, and Watt, and plenty of good offensive linemen. They're pretty good for, I mean, for football, where you normally think, like, SEC puts out the good skill dudes. The Big Ten puts out some good receivers and stuff lately, too. So, anyway, moving on. What are my top five country cities outside of America? Is that like a thing to have, like, top five cities? Like, do people do that? Oh, fuck me in the ass. No! Oh my God, he didn't even see me. He didn't even fucking see me. He was retarded, and I ran right at him, and I was red. How did they get the care package from dying? I'll take it. I'm like, I'm not going to complain about that, but... top five cities... Maybe, like, top five cities I want to visit? We'll go with that. A Talon. This will be fun. I would really like to visit... never been to New York City. I do like Las Vegas, so that would be... I guess one of my top five cities that I have been. I like Vegas a lot. I think it's a really cool city. Kind of like trashy too. I don't know what the word for it is, but it's like you get a bunch of out-of-towners, out-of-countryers, foreigners who are... It's funny because people go there and their goal when they go there, especially when they're from like a different country, is to like pretend they're like really wealthy. So you see a bunch of people who like have on their like their polo assassin tee or polo shirts with the fucking big ass horse on it, whatever. But the people always try to put this front on that they're loaded in Vegas. So I don't like that. I wish everybody would kind of just be a little bit more laid back and not so like, hey, I'm better than you because I'm wearing this shirt, even though I smell bad because I haven't showered. But I do like Vegas a lot. I like Chicago. Chicago's a cool city. So I gotta give Chicago some love. I think it's beautiful. We went there for 4th of July. Not this year, but last year. And gorgeous city. Gorgeous. A little bit too much crime. But obviously, I think that comes with any big city, so... Do these guys not... Okay, so one guy saw me. The rest of them did. If we can stop them here, that would be fucking huge. I think we're automatically going to win anyway. I think our team's better. I think we have more talent. I think we're more talented. You're not good. Come on, fucking get them. Come on, baby. There's nobody over there to stop them. Nobody over there. That's okay, though. 4:37. That's plenty of time. Okay. Sorry if I've been skipping out on some of the questions. Top five country cities that... Oh, that I want to travel to. I forgot seeing that part. Okay. Nice job stealing my wrench, you whore. God, I don't know. I would like to go to Italy. I would like to visit Australia. I've never been to New York City, so we gotta put that up there. I do like Vegas. I always like traveling there. Trying to think. I don't know. I think we'll end it there. I don't know what else. Q&A, would you rather live in Alaska or never drink Red Bull again? I love Red Bull. Why am I not getting credit for escorting this thing? Do I have to be the first one there? Whatever. Oh, now I'm getting credit for it. Like, what? How does it decide? Like, what are the rules here? Oh, Jesus. There was too much shit going on in there. I'm waiting to get spawn trapped by Doom Spawn Trap. But he's yet to do anything productive, so... I would probably rather never drink Red Bull again, because I can find an alternative. You know, like... Oh, Jesus! See, that's why I should have used my axe. Right there. That should have been it. Could have got a fucking six-man. Wonder where those axes landed. Push it, push it, push it! You know they're coming in here. They like coming in here. Start moving it. Start moving it for me. Come on. Come on. Don't come in here and take my kills. There we go. Oh, no. All right. I guess I'll fuck it. I'll move it myself. Guys, come on. We're trying to move this thing. There we go. Much better. Let's get a little bank shot off of there. I'll start escorting it. I don't care. I want to win. Shit, guys. Shit. Yikes! Alright, we're moving it, we're moving it. Let's keep going. Fuck my ass. Guys, we have 2.5 minutes to move it about 50 feet. Do you think we can do it? Do you think we can do it? What the fuck? Jesus Christ, you're awful. I mean, I wasn't good either, but Jesus. Their person? I don't know where he went. Let's pretend he doesn't exist. Nice aim, bud. Nice aim, bud. Nice aim, bud. Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Victory. Easy W. Easy W. Okay. Okay, how far into this are we? I think we gotta stop it there. I'm having a lot of fun, though. So I don't want to stop it, but I think if we go any past 54 minutes or whatever, you guys are going to probably die. Anyway, thank you very much. Let's get one final question. What time of the day do I record these? How about that? From the God 747. Right now it is 12:42. I normally start recording them depending on when I wake up. It's normally the first thing I do in the day. So today I woke up at 11, and the rest is history. So pretty much... early in the day is when I do it. But thank you guys very, very, very much for the support. Again, the goal is 1,000 likes. There's 1,000 people watching and listening right now. If all you guys hit the like button, we'd hit it easily. No questions asked. And everybody would be happy and we'd be throwing parties and stuff. So thank you very much for watching. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe. And make sure you're caught up on this series because you don't want to fall behind. Okay? Okay. I love you. Peace.